Tonight on 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, John Richardson, Roisin Conaty, Rob Beckett, Kiri Richard McLean, Huge Davies, Susie Dent, Rachel Riley, and your host, Jimmy Cobb.
Hello and welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show about letters, numbers and conundrums. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's team captain John Richardson. John Richardson, he's like a vaccine, but for fun.
Do you want to get injected?
And John's teammate this evening is Rob Beckett.
Hello. There you go.
Rob Beckett, finally an answer to the question, what would it look like if during the war, Nazi scientists had tried to genetically engineer an Aryan horse?
Ja, das Blondhoffen ist gut, ja.
Go easy on our face.
Exactly. Considering it's coming from a man that's engineered his entire face and hair. When can I talk about your hair?
Anytime you want. What would you like?
Because you've had a transplant, which I thought was a bit early doors for you. I didn't think you needed it. Is this what you're going for, or you? Is this, midpoint?
This is a midpoint.
What's the end goal?
I want to have eyebrows, a small bit of forehead, maybe a two head,
yep.
And then hair starting about there.
At the moment, you look a little bit like Woody from Toy Story.
That's not the hair, though, I don't think.
What's that?
That's not the hair.
No.
It's the frozen face. If you spend too much time with Catherine Ryan, this is what happens.
No, you got her into that.
Up against them this evening, it's guest team captain Roisin Conaty. Sorry, Roish. Carol Bunga.
Can we edit that out?
What was that?
It was panic.
What was that?
It was meant to be ironic, but then I realised, is that a mouse? No. It was meant to be like ironic with something on that curtain, but it's not a mouse. But then this happened. Can we edit that out?
If anything embarrasses me, I'm just going to try and distract attention. Is that a mouse? Roisin says if she wasn't a comedian, she'd be a country singer. Well, if you did that, Roisin, I'm sure comedy's loss would be country music's problem. would you be a country singer? Is that your thing?
Country singer? Yeah, I still write really long country and western songs when I was young. But yes, I sing songs like Get Up In The Morning. I'm not singing them now.
Yeah! Well, a little bit, I think. Them.
Get up in the morning, have first aid, go into the bathroom, brush my teeth and wash my face, go downstairs, have toast and soft-boiled egg. I was going to be a country western singer and then my cousin's boyfriend... When I was about 11, I was just starting secondary school, and I was writing all my songs. Just my practice. It was absolute given that I was going to be a country singer. And he said, "Well, it's such a shame you haven't got a voice, isn't it?" Aww. And I was like, "Yeah." And I walked out of the bedroom because it was my bedroom, and I slid down the wall really dramatically, like I was in Dawson's Creek. Like, oh God, I have to find a job. I can't sing.
Okay. And joining Roisin tonight, it's Kiri Pritchard McLean. Kiri has a unique dress sense and achieves her distinctive look by covering herself in Pritstick and rolling around backstage at Strictly.
This is just covered in dancers' pubes.
I mean, you always wear spangles, though, right?
Stunning.
Well, yeah, I just think it's a bit of showbiz. And I the first time I ever did a gig, I was introduced on stage as a man, and everyone just thought I was a drag queen, and I just sort of stuck with that. And I want people to be wondering what my genitalia is. That's my, like, default position for a gig.
Well, now I'm thinking about your genitalia.
Thank God.
Yeah, I was before, so it's actually helped me.
I don't know what it looks like, but I imagine it's cut to ribbons, depending on how far down those sequins.
Do you know what? Sometimes I'll go for a wee, and there'll be a sequin in the toilet. Oh. And before now, I've had it where it's not even the colour I'm wearing. So I don't know where that sequin was.
You've had sequins fall out of you?
Yeah, just fall out of me like a really glamorous pinata when I've gone for a wee.
But you've got very attractive kidney stones.
Ooh. Oh, I'd love that.
You're a smooth bastard.
Rob, you finished writing your first book. How does it feel to be an author?
Fucking long, innit? Write a book. You've written a book?
I've written a book, yeah.
It takes a long time. But what I've worked out is you don't need to read a book to write a book.
Have Have you now written more than you've read?
Yeah, because I've not read all of mine. Well, no, no, I know what happened, but you don't need to read books to write a book. Like this, I'm not very good at this, but I know enough words to get by. Why? I'm an efficiency man. Why waste time knowing words I'm not going to use? No offence, Susie, you've got a career out of it, but what I'm saying is there's a lot of words in that book that won't affect me, and I don't need to know.
When you say it's a book, is it more of a pamphlet? It sounds like it might be quite... It feels like it might be quite brief.
To be fair, it's a good book, and it's... I'll just plug it. It's a fine book. By the book, it's about class.
It's the worst
and
the... plug I've ever heard.
Is it?
How long did it take you to write your book?
Four months.
Yeah, why not? If you're going to make it up, why not 4 months?
Guys, I'm trying to plug my book.
I think you've done it with the phrase, to be fair, it's a good book.
To be fair, it's a good book. I'll go again. Yeah, I've written a book. I've put my heart and soul into it.
Kira, you're Welsh. Are there any Welsh words we should be aware of?
Yeah, well, there's a beautiful phrase. Sglinio fel ceilliau ci, which is really quite poetic. And it's if you're saying something is very beautiful, and it translates into sparkles like the testicles of a dog.
Is it just in your house? Because I imagine your dog has got a fair amount of glitter on his box. What is it again?
Sglinio fel ceilliau ci.
Can you say it forwards?
So I think I use that in my book, trying to spell definitely.
Rob, have you got a mascot? What have you brought?
Oh, yes. I've been struggling to socialise. Now we're all allowed out and about and doing things. I find it a bit overwhelming. And also, I've sort of quite enjoyed not having to be too near people.
Go on.
I've got a few bits and bobs. So, like, I've got a mask with my face smiling on it, so it looks like I'm engaged in the conversation.
Oh, that's good.
Well, that is fantastic.
So that's handy. Cos now it's awkward, isn't it, with elbows and fist bumps. So now... Hello, Jim, nice to meet you.
That is great.
That's good, isn't it?
That looks like...
You shake your hand?
I can't touch that now, cos Jimmy's touched it. Can I?
1 second.
This looks like some sort of sexy thing now.
Yeah.
Oh, no. No.
This is going to feel slightly erotic, isn't it? I'm just going to slide into it.
That's good, isn't it?
Lovely.
That's all COVID secure. I've got...
What's this?
This is a bangle that is also a hip flask.
Ooh! Wow.
So you can wear this out to, the, you know, wherever you're going out, and then when, you know, to get it cheaper, when they're not looking...
There's something about when you wear it, it looks like the police have made you wear it.
And also, it just looks like you're an absolute wrong and in a bar. If you saw a man doing that in the bar, you'd be like, who's he with and who do we need to tell?
Yeah, so I've got these glasses that I've got my eyes on, so it looks like you're engaged.
With the mask.
With the mask.
And now do that drink thing and try and look like you're not going to get arrested.
Do you know what the great thing about that is? You can have a conversation about word derivations with Susie Dent.
Yeah. Susie, what's your favourite word? Perfect, isn't it? Yeah, and also I've got 101 conversation starters.
Oh,
cool. We're sort of out the loop, aren't we? Okay, I don't know what glasses work. Hang on. So, what is your greatest fear? Aging. I'll answer for you. who would win in a bare knuckle fight between Jimmy or John?
Ooh.
What do you think?
I think John.
I'd be very 1930s boxer. I'm not for all this modern nonsense.
No, because that's what
I'd be like that.
I bite.
what's your signature dish, Rico?
Scrambled tofu. See, I've got a book called 101 Conversation Finishers.
Okay,
Kiri, have you got a mascot?
Yes, I have. This is inspired by my nerves today and the fact I'm quite bad at counting. So I brought a menstrual cup.
Ooh. I just think my minstrel's out the bag.
Does anyone use them in here?
I've never really found cause to.
Well, get into it. I never remember when my period is, so I come on and stress brings it on, so I was worried about it today. It's basically like a little rubber sherry glass where every month you sort of toast the end of your fertility. And people who use them are really evangelical about them. They'll try and get you to use them as well. It's like a cult, but we wear our uniform on the inside.
She said cult. Roisin, have you got a mascot? Ideally, something that hasn't been inside you.
Well, no, I don't then.
It says here you've got an idea for a TV show about animals. What's the idea?
Animals meeting animals. Animals who wouldn't normally meet animals meet them. Donkey meets a monkey. Hello. That's it.
Does one travel to the other? Yeah. Like, does donkey and go so... to Africa? Or is it like a first dates thing where...
Yeah, they go to Fernando's.
It's a neutral
like...
venue.
Yeah, no, they go to where, sort of, the, I suppose, where the most sort of skittish one, they get to choose.
So you take the donkey to the leopard, because leopards are a bit more skittish.
Leopards I'd probably leave out of my first series.
They're hard to find.
You want to stick with an owl, maybe meeting a rabbit.
I think that's going to end in a dead rabbit.
Yeah. What happens after? It's Sunday afternoon, and you just watch them, maybe put cups of tea around them so it looks like they're meeting up.
Cross between a cockfight and the old PG tips.
I'd watch that.
Of course you would. Sunday afternoon, what else would you watch?
What's the show called?
Animals Meeting Animals. Keep it simple.
Okay. John, have you got a mascot? What did you bring?
I've been working very hard, Jimmy, to bring this show into the 21st century. In terms of its carbon footprint, you know. We've got to move forward.
Sure,
we've all
got
to make changes to save the bloody planet, right? Mm-hmm. For example, I was going to drive here today, and I didn't. I got a taxi. Two of us in the car sharing. That's better for the environment. Now, a lot of people don't know as well, because of the year this show started and the size of that thing, that clock is coal-powered. There's a furnace behind there. All that happens when Jimmy presses his button... The furnace gets stoked. The poor lad who's under there. Up you come, Andy, out from the furnace room. Poor sod's been under there since 1982. So I've replaced all this with a now fully carbon neutral clock. That also keeps Andy in the show. So press your button.
Boom!
He's faster, so we'll be out of here in 20 minutes. He only does 10 seconds. You've either got it or you haven't. Let's get on. Get out of here.
I think we're going to stick with the old clock.
Sorry, Andy, back in the furnace room.
That's right. Bless him. Bless him your heart.
Now, one of the other things I've been doing is the fashion industry is one of the most polluting industries on the planet. It's absolutely deadly. The water that goes into making clothes, where the dyes end up, the microplastics, everything you buy, you basically might as well just go and kill a dolphin in the wild after it's had the chance to meet a tortoise.
Thank you. Thank you, John.
So what I do is I reuse clothes. So I go through... I didn't know you...
You reuse clothes?
You only wear... Well, Jimmy only wears a jacket once. So I get all Jimmy's jackets out of his bin. They're bloody big. I thought we were the same size, but I'm such a little man. And also, like, it's not just your clothes. I mean, we're all at it. Your maternity clothes, Rachel, found those all in the bin. Mm. So don't mind if I do have a bit of a reuse.
Go to the
shoes.
Can you see a bit more of that? Can we see the shoes? Could you stand on the desk?
John, I can help you get out there. Don't worry, do you want to hand out?
I see what you have for breakfast.
Jeez. In rehearsal, the slit was on the other side. Our shoes wouldn't fit. These are my heels. I like the boost.
John Richardson, everyone. Over in Dictionary Corner, it's Huge Davies. Huge Davies is Indonesian Welsh. I won't attempt the accent. Now, it's your first time on the show. Could you tell us a little bit about yourself?
I'm Huge Davies, and I have a very close relationship with my father. So I thought the best way to demonstrate that would be to play a little song about me and my father. So here we go. Walking down the street with my dad, he holds my hand, I look up. It's not my dad, it's just a random man. He puts me in a van.
Thank you.
it's part one. The random man pulls off a mask. It's actually my dad. We both laugh and drive off down the road to an orphanage. He swaps me for a bike. Continue on to part three. The orphanage was just a dream. I wake up in my bed, but someone's painted all the windows black. I'm in a sack. I'm still in the stranger's van.
Huge donors, everyone. And with huge, of course, it's Susie Dent. Susie's latest book was accidentally printed with lots of mistakes. Well then, Susie, it's a good job no one's going to read it. So what were the printing errors? What did they get wrong?
They used a very early typesetting file with loads of typesetting errors in it, and it was called Word Perfect.
How many did they have to pulp?
Quite a few. I've got loads in my attic in case they ever become valuable.
Spoiler alert, they don't.
I don't know that. She could kill.
Yeah.
That's true. And in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. Rachel, you are pregnant, so are you going to do anything differently this time round?
I think when you have your first one, you kind of learn on the job as a parent, don't you? You know, you just get proud of really stupid things that they learn how to do. So she learned how to dip something in the hummus. We were like, that's amazing. Gave her some breadsticks in the park, told her to hurry along, wondered what she was doing, and she was dipping her breadsticks into a puddle.
Could have been much worse in the park, in fairness. OK, the prize the teams will be competing for tonight is this, the Countdown Cocktail Set. Ooh! OK, let's count down, everyone. Time for the first game. John, Rob, you get the first pick of the letters.
Over to you, Rob.
Yes, just whatever you fancy, Rachel.
Yeah, OK.
Some of the Vs, some of the Cs.
We'll go with R,
That's A, C.
D, E, M, A, P, I, and a final S.
One, two, one, two, three, four. John, how many letters?
Seven.
Rob, how many?
Five.
What was it?
Drape.
Roisin, how many?
Six.
Kiri, how many?
A five that's right and a six I don't think's a word.
What are you going to roll the dice on?
Oh, come on, dream it.
What do you think, Roisin?
You need to just sort of say them both and then just argue.
Prism, five.
OK, Roisin, what's your word?
Dreams, baby.
Hi, John, what was your word?
I got despair.
How are you writing on that?
This is another thing I'm doing to decrease the carbon footprint. I dried all the paper towels in the paper towel bin in the toilet. Put them on the radiator. Because you've already washed your hands, so technically they're clean. I mean, the backs, sometimes people blow their notes.
OK, so 7 points to Johnson. Susie, could they have done any better?
Paradise is their eight.
So at the end of that, John and Rob are in the lead with 7 points. OK, on to our first numbers round. Roisin and Kiri, your turn to pick the numbers.
I'm really bad at this, so I'm going to trust you. You're more experienced.
Yes. You'd be right to trust me.
This is the blind leading the blind, isn't it?
May I have, Rachel, loads of numbers. One from the top.
One from the top. Are you sure you don't want two?
Two from the top. And then what do I normally say?
You normally say, oh, shit, can we stop it? Can we stop it, please?
I recommend two.
Thanks, Rachel.
We've got five, 10,
there you go.
7, 10, 50 and 25. And the target, 908.
Your time starts now. So the target was 9:08. Did you get it, Kiri?
I got 9:13.
Roisin, did you get it?
Did I get it?
Yeah, did you... did you get it?
I want to say no this time.
Sounds like you were very close. What did you get?
What did I get? I got 25 plus 50 is 75.
I think you're gonna, you can get to two away from this.
Okay, 7 plus 5
That's
is...
That's a great one, times is 12. Yes.
Yes. And then times 75.
For 900, obviously.
Plus 10.
Then that gets you to two away, 910. Ooh.
Surprised you don't get more acting work, because it felt to me like you'd never done that before while you were while you were talking. I really believed that you didn't have a fucking clue what
Rob, did you get
it? Can I tell you what happened? Yeah. I did 50 times 10.
Yeah.
And then I had a pain in my eye.
Oh, here we go.
I got to that, and the more I was thinking about it, the pain got worse. So I thought, I either stop thinking or I go home. So I got 500, Jim. But I just thought it's good having it on the board, because if someone got 498, I'm closer.
OK. John, did you get it?
I got 907.
One away, so how did you do?
I did 25 plus... 10.
Sorry, what is that?
It's recycled toilet paper. Sometimes you've got to go through a full process, and sometimes you just, if you use it twice, it's recycled. 25 plus 10 plus 5 plus 50 is 90, times by 10.
Times the other 10, 900.
And add the 7.
Well done, one away.
7 points for John. Rachel, could it be done?
I found a way. Just
you
one
found
way.
A way.
Just one way.
There's
if
just one
you
way.
You say 25 minus 7 is 18, times by 50 is 900, and then add 10, and the other 10 divided by 5 is 2 to take away.
Wow. Mm.
Yeah. OK, so Roisin and Kiri have no points. John and Rob have 14. And here is your teaser. The words are turd pose. The clue is it's popping out. That's turd pose. It's popping out. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser. The words were turd pose. The clue was it's popping out. It was, of course, sprouted. So... John and Rob are in the lead with 14 points. OK, they've been playing in teams so far, but this next game is just for Roisin and Rob.
Oh, blonde on blonde.
Roisin, your turn to choose.
Here we go.
Rach, may I have, what are they again? A vowel, please?
Yep.
E. Two consonants.
T.
L.
Two vowels, please.
A and
I.
And the rest consonants, please.
Y. B and R and M.
OK, and your time starts now. Watch and learn.
OK.
Ooh. Watch and learn. OK, here we go.
Save it.
Fancy go at the...
Yeah,
if you do it, you'll be a miracle.
What, from here?
Yeah, come on. Come on, from there. Come on.
Oh!
Rim job.
No look. Yeah, I should have looked. I can see why they look now.
Oh.
Oh! Nothing but net.
Nothing but net. Normally, your teammates go wild, but, you know, whatever, John.
Check out the tubby mermaid.
This looks like John's act for a cruise ship.
Wow,
oh, wow.
You having a good time, kids? Pull yourself to the buffet.
Roisin, how many?
Five.
Five? OK, and Rob, how many?
Seven.
Roisin, your five-letter word.
Nosy little so-and-so, aren't you?
I'm sorry, I shouldn't pry.
Bream.
Bream.
Yes.
And Rob, what did you go for?
Reality.
Oh.
Rob, everyone.
Thanks, Rob.
Susie, could they have done any better?
I think seven is probably the best. There were loads of sevens.
Remember, guys, I couldn't have done any better. I've got a three-pointer and 7 points in the... What's this round called?
Letters.
The letters round.
Huge. How did you do in this?
There is an Indonesian four in there as well.
Oh. Go on, what's
it's,
that?
It's Y-E-T-I. It's Yeti. That's... it means Yeti. It means the same thing.
When does a abominable snowman get involved? What's that?
What kind of a snowman?
Yeah, you know what I meant.
No, but what kind of snowman? What kind of a snowman was it?
Big one. What abominable. Do you know what I found out the other day? Minutiae is not said minutae. Why don't they put a C and an H in?
Minutiae.
But why is there a T there?
Because it goes back to Latin.
Fucking it's always Latin, isn't it? It's always Latin. It's been ages ago, Latin. No one keeps talking about teletext. Why are we fucking about with Latin?
I did think the word statuesque when I was 23. I said out loud, she's quite statuesque, that woman.
I thought the phrase was horses, fuck horses.
That works.
Horses fuck
works
horses.
Better. Yeah. It's a better phrase.
Welcome to Animals Meet the Animals.
Thank you. My friend.
OK, time now to go across to Dictionary Corner. Huge, what have you got for us?
Well, I've been thinking about the park quite a lot. So here's my song about going to the park. So here we go. We can now walk in the park, on the path and on the grass. Look at the kids on the swings, they're so happy. People about to sit to have a lovely picnic. Oh look, that family is doing a bike ride. But what do I like to do when I'm in the park, asks you? I like to dress as an Arsenal coach. Stand near people playing football with a clipboard. They think that I'm scouting them when I'm on my iPhone and I'm watching Shrek. Get up every Saturday to the park where fellas play incredibly hard to try and impress me, cos I'm not a normal coach, I'm just a normal bloke. Occasionally I'll say, square it, lads, come on, square it. But I'm not a football coach, I play the piano. Oh, I like to dress as an Arsenal coach and stand near people playing football. Then I invite them to take part in a secret trial, because they're playing football in the Arsenal style. They show up at the secret trial. I say my coaching staff and I only take the most talented players here at Arsenal Football Club. I ask them as a test of strength to move a sofa, then a bed. You remind me of a young Patrick Vieira. Amazing. They take a large bed down the stairs and then they take a stack of chairs. I like to dress as an Arsenal coach and stand near people playing football because I am moving. Yeah, it's true, I'm moving house, yeah. I'd like some footballers to help me out. I'm using my position as an Arsenal coach. I've managed to move most of my stuff on the cheap. If you'd like help moving out, join me on the touchline as an Arsenal scout.
OK, the scores at the moment, Roisin and Kiri have no points, John and Rob have 21 points.
How many points do we have? Me and Susie. I've seen her writing down stuff all the time. I learned the piano for this fucking shit.
You don't have any points.
on a level with them.
In fairness, the audience are also level with Kerry and Roisin. Neck and neck with Roisin and Kerry, who I imagine is going to fly at me, am I correct?
I'm thinking of other ways to get to you faster than flying. I'm thinking of time travelling so I can be there when you go to say it and then... Yeah, that could be any part of your body.
Oh,
not the hair. Oh, has it got tips?
Okay, here is your teaser. The words are rod in gob, and the clue is I need to think about that. That's rod in gob. I need to think about that. See you after the break. For the teaser, the words were rod in gob. The clue was, I need to think about that. It was, of course, brooding. OK, before we go on, time for a special treat. We have a magician performing tonight. please welcome the amazing Alfonso.
That's a shame. I asked for dancers that weren't pricks, but never mind. All right?
Yeah, so are you going to do a trick for us tonight?
Yeah, I'm going to do a trick with a lion. What I'm going to do, I'm going to put my head in its mouth and then I'm going to squeeze its nuts. See what happens.
Have you ever done a trick with a lion before?
No, but I've been drinking, so confidence is high. Come on, lads. Here it comes. Oh, you found one. I didn't think they'd find one. That's backfired. Do you know what? I'm going to do a card trick. Sorry, lads. Fair play, though. Rachel, would you mind helping me with a trick?
Yeah.
Sanitize! Front and back. Front and back. Or just do your hands, it's up to you. Pick a card, any card, right, go near the middle.
This one, please.
Yeah, but don't show me, but show other people. Okay. So I'm going to guess your card. Here we go.
Okay.
Fuck off. Hold on. Just fuck off. Just fuck off. Keep one at the end. Bag him up. There's absolutely no way I could guess your card, right?
Not that I'm aware of.
Okay. Explain this. Okay, it's further away than I remember. Initially, it was here, wasn't it? Chat amongst yourselves. I was going to check what I sent the printer. Yeah, that's what I sent him. That's meant to be on my duvet cover. That's meant to be the Eight of Clubs. Was your card the Eight of Clubs?
No.
Cock.
It's the Ten of Spades.
OK. Well, this might surprise you. Why not do this? Yeah. I clicked the option that says print on both sides. It worked. Let's play countdown!
OK, on with the game. John and Rob, your turn to choose the letters.
Can we have three vowels, please?
Yeah. U, A, E.
Three consonants.
P, T, and D.
What else you want, John? More of a V or more of a C?
More consonants, please.
More C's, please.
H, K, and E.
And your time starts now. How many letters, John?
Six.
Rob, how many letters?
Four again.
Kerry, how many?
Four.
Roisin?
Six.
Ooh.
Kerry, you're four.
The, as in like Shakespeare, the with two E's.
Oh, the.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's two E's. They're slap bang in the middle of my deep.
John, you're
I
six?
Really want to find out what's happening with Roisin, because I think something more visually exciting is happening.
She keeps writing down things after the clock. Which
hate doesn't... mail to you. Dear Rob, stop grassing me up.
John, you're six?
Uptake.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Uptake. You're six, Roisin.
Thud up.
What's it?
Thud up.
Thud up.
No. Thud up with a D. T H U D E P. Thud up.
Yeah, when
thud
you up. Drop something.
Thud up. Could you use it in a
Thank
sentence?
Thank you.
Please?
Joe just said what it was.
Yeah, you drop something. Oh, thud up. I threw it.
At last, thud someone up. With an education.
Yeah.
Is that in the dictionary?
Well, I think it was in the English dialect dictionary, which was published in the 19th century.
Yes.
But it's not in this dictionary.
OK, 6 points to John. Susie, could they have done any better?
Not a lot, no. They were just sixes. So, update, peaked, path.
Look, I've got to fly! I've got to fly! I've got to fly! Yes! Gone. Lost it, sorry. Sorry. I should have kept that to myself. I just caught a fly. I've been following it for an hour. I got my moment.
But it came out of you.
Yeah, I know it did.
OK, time now to go across the dictionary corner. Huge, what have you got for us?
Jimmy, during lockdown, I've, you know, had some trouble sleeping. You know, I've had some very, some bad dreams. I've recurring mundane dreams every single night. And, the first mundane recurring dream I have is I want a double-decker chocolate bar. So I go to the 24-hour shop near where I live, I buy a double-decker chocolate bar, go back to my flat, I eat the chocolate bar, then I wake up. So what I do is I go to the 24-hour shop near where I live, I buy a double-decker chocolate bar, go back to my flat, I eat the chocolate bar, then I've lived my dream. The second recurring mundane dream I have is I'm approached by both Bolas and Gromit, who finger, then kill me. Yeah, but what you don't know is that dream is actually being filmed in stop motion, so the whole thing takes months. The third recurring mundane dream I have, which is the most mundane of all, it's just this song. This goes on and on like this. And the minutes turn into hours, and the hours into days, and the days into weeks. And then I see my children die. And then my grandchildren too, they die as well. And all the time, this song is just playing all the way through. And then I realise I'm sleeping through my alarm. It's like...
Huge Davis, everyone. And here is your final teaser. The words are minge-air. The clue is... It'll... And here is your final teaser. The words are minge-air. The clue is it'll blur your vision.
Oh, yeah.
That's minge-air. See you after the break. answer to the tease. The words were minge. The clue was it'll blur your vision. It was, of course, migraine. OK, time for our final letters game. Roisin, Kiri, your turn to choose.
Kiri?
Yes.
Your turn to choose.
Please, may I have two vowels?
I and E.
Then two consonants.
G.
Yeah.
And T.
One vowel. And the rest consonants.
O.
How many vowels we've got?
W.
We got C.
And the last one, L.
OK, and your 30 seconds starts now.
You have three new messages.
Mr Carr, it's Justine from Channel 4 here. I'm afraid your application for Naked Attraction has been rejected. But I've passed on your photos to embarrassing bodies.
Hello, Jimmy, dear boy. I just wanted to thank you for last night. You made me feel 10 years younger. It was like I were 89 again.
Hi, Jimmy. It's your assistant here. Just wanted to let you know that I've had enough. I quit. Oh, and I jibbed in your coffee.
How many?
Six.
Six? Cool. Okay, John, how many?
Yeah, six, I think.
Kiri, how many?
I think it's spelled wrong, but six.
Roisin?
Five.
What's your five, Roisin?
Tower.
Kiri, you're six?
Trowel.
Susie?
Yes.
Yeah, you're...
Yes.
Yeah,
yes.
With that?
Oh,
okay.
Yes.
Yeah.
OK. Rob, you're six?
Coiler.
Ooh.
Someone that does a bit of coiling.
That coiler isn't in, Rob, I'm afraid.
John, you're six?
Glower.
Oh, oh, nice.
Oh. Well, 6 points for both James.
He's got points. The underdog story is starting. Yes.
It's a lock around.
Oh.
Yeah, I think. Yeah, the comeback trail, I think you've left it a bit late. Yeah.
Is there no more maths?
Is there no more maths?
Yeah.
No more maths today, yeah.
Quality. No more maths, no more pain.
So just attempting the maths on this show gives you a headache.
Yeah, because I just see it's just pointless, isn't it? Because we've got calculators now.
I think you should have a calculator to see if it would actually help.
It would. I'll tell you now. I wouldn't need, like, sin, cos, tan and all that. Just you. Just the one on my phone.
Could you explain what sin, cos, tan are for any maths?
Some Pythagoras shit, probably Greek or Latin, isn't it? Something I got told about at school, never needed in my life. But what's that? Self-assessment tax return? Don't worry about that. Just fuck about with algebra.
Self-assessment what? Susie, could they have done any better?
Cowgirl was there for seven.
Oh.
Yeah.
I actually write cowgirl down in a search engine most days, and I can't believe I missed it.
Oh, you mucky pup.
We're allowed to hug now.
You can't say any of that in Australia.
I'm just saying, though, if we wanted to have sex, it wouldn't be illegal. Me and you.
We've got finale for the show.
Just new rules. New life, new me. I'm post-COVID.
That was the only thing that was stopping you before?
It's not a sexual thing. It's more an intrigue of what is underneath the suit. I don't think I'll get off on it, and I don't think I'll do it again, but what a story I'd have.
Rob, I wouldn't bother. He makes you sign something.
OK, so Roisin and Kiri have 6 points. John and Rob have 33 points. OK, fingers on buzzers. Time for today's Countdown Conundrum. Your time starts now. Keeps you warm in winter time.
A coat.
Okay, it's not a coat.
Okay.
Roisin.
No.
Okay, let's find out what it was.
Oh, I saw a fireplace and I thought, I can't believe it.
Yeah, it's just been popped up on there.
So the final scores are Roisin and Kiri have 6 points, John and Rob have 33. Congratulations, you're now the proud owners of this, the Countdown Cocktail Set. Thanks to all our panellists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
Sharpen up. I literally just told you Jimmy Carr's quiz with the answers already in. Stream now on All Four. Or Jamie Lee O'Donnell. She's the probie on the wing in Long Marsh Men's Prison. Big cast for a big new drama. Screw. But coming up, get sewn in for a bumper edition of Gogglebox.